So recently, Mama Harris, our vice president of America, the female in charge of a lot of things, has been getting a lot of disregard and disrespect in the media, and I am quite familiar with the left wing. But what I can tell you is that woman has more experience than most in terms of taking care of legal situations for people who do and don't deserve it, and openly caring for America under the terms of the law. And that is what made her the best pick of all. You see, Papa Biden could have looked over the entire set of Democratic people who wanted to run for president, and he had to make a choice. Who's going to be the best running mate for me? Who's going to be the best person for the country? And who's going to be best based on my experience of being motherfucking vice president, which is the underling to a president? So I don't know what the hell people are talking about when they say that he is out of date, out of time, out of whatever. No, he's not. It's his career path to be president. It's his gift from the Lord to be president. It's his responsibility in front of God. My God, what a president that would be. In front of God to be president. And what I mean is, you got a hell of a lot of accountability. How many people are in America? How many people are he accountable for? And that was bad grammar, but I apologize for that. But what I'm saying is, when it comes to Mama Harris, she has her own magnificent skill sets. And let me tell you, motherfuckers, none of you are perfect. And she is learning her way in a vice president way. I bet every fucking man who's held that position had had to learn something about that position. I guarantee all the vice presidents across the realm of history of America had to learn something about being vice president. They still have the responsibility of meeting with world dignitaries after the president probably does, in a way that is appropriate to the level of a prefectural prime minister from another part of the world. We have world ties we have to keep. We have world treaties we must meet. We have local laws that cannot be defeated, but we have people that want to live in defeat. And those who live in defeat dishonor the White House. There's a reason they use that logo on those videos and on those clips, because what we're positioning ourselves in the world is that the White House stands time and time again, no matter how many men, how many women work in that position, work in that corporation, work to serve America, Inc. In America, we have rights, and the rights that we have in America are about what our rights are in America. Our rights as American citizens are different than visitors who come here wishing to be American citizens. Look at the Mexican border. What a mess it is. Send them home. If they didn't make the travel money for the journey to go home, they were foolish. They might starve to death, but that was the stupidity of them. We are not responsible for feeding them, although we could do a humanitarian effort to feed them. That is true. We can produce the soup pots. We can produce the stew pots. We can produce the poop pots. We can produce all of that for them to live outside on somebody else's nation of our border today. But openly, it doesn't allow them to enter in and stay. What did they do to apply for a visa lawfully, legally, in any way? What is their right to be here? I have to say, I can't say. What are they going to do to support our economy? What are they going to do to build our economy? What are they going to do to keep and safeguard you and me today? I'd like to know that, because I haven't ever seen that in the rare person who's stupid enough to mention to me, either in truth or in jest, that they're not a legitimate citizen. I know that when my spouse was here, she followed every law. I know that when my son was here, he did not do them all, but openly he had to pay for that in every way. And openly it affected his future here to stay. But now that they're lost, now that they're not here anymore, now that they are considered late people in my family, and when I say my late spouse and my late son, I mean that. They were never late, technically, like my elder brother was always late to every fucking family event, but that's not the point. He never learned how to be disciplined like me. What his gifts are don't matter to me is somewhat truthful, because when you abuse me, I don't like that, but let me not get off track. Mama Harris is the person who is currently on track for the next presidency. So she's got much to learn, many relationships to earn, and many bridges sometimes to burn, to safeguard America, to safeguard our property, to safeguard our land, to safeguard our houses, to safeguard our possessions, and to safeguard you and me.